When someone is counting out gold for you, don't look at your hands or the gold, look at the giver. You cannot be given that which you do not deserve. One thing. Second thing, the giver gives only that which he is. The giver can never give more than what he is. The giver can also never give anything different from what he is. Often, if you just look at what you are being given, you might be mistaken. Because you have no eyes to understand the significance of what you are receiving. Gold sounds attractive. Hence, you would feel as if you are being given something beneficial, something valuable. But when you are actually being given gold, then gold does not always come as gold. Gold may come to you as lumps of soil. In fact, gold is found in its natural state only as and only in lumps of soil. So do not really see what is coming to you. See from where is it coming to you. If it is coming to you from a loving source, accept it even if the gift looks unsavory, even if the gift looks distasteful, even if the gift looks actually harmful. But if it is coming from the right giver, just take it. The giver matters, not the gift. At the same time, if the gift is not coming from the right giver, then reject it even if the gift appears very, very attractive and beneficial. It does not matter what you are being given. What matters is who is giving it to you, from where is the gift arising. From your beloved, take even poison. The poison will kill only the fake within you. And from someone who knows no love, refuse to accept even ambrosia. From him, even ambrosia would be like poison for you. Are you getting it? Also, there is no need to feel responsible for or take credit for what you receive. there is a clear difference between the fake giver and the real giver. The fake giver gives you something because you deserve it. The real giver gives you something because of your simple being. The fake giver says, there is something extraordinary about you, hence I am giving something to you. The real giver says, I am not even judging your merit. What you are getting is not based on merit. Hence, there is no need to check your qualification or eligibility. You are not giving, you are not getting it because of your eligibility. You are just getting it. You are simply getting it. The fake giver gives it to you because in some way you are qualified or special. He gives it to you either because you look attractive or because you can pay back the giver in some way. Which means that the giving will be directly proportional to what you can offer in return. If what you get is based on your merit, then you will only get something little. You will only get as much as you can reciprocate. The real giver does not love you because of your merit. He does not love you because of any reason. He just loves. Rumi is saying, look at the giver. Does he love you for a reason? If he loves you for a reason, then his love is going to be both limited and temporary. All reasons have a way of disappearing. The day the reason disappears, his love too will disappear. No reason is ever absolute, and no reason is ever strong enough to stand the test of time. Rumi is saying, do not look at your hands, do not look at yourself. If you are really getting something, it would be not because you are special or qualified or meritorious. The greatest of gifts are not obtained based on merit. They are just obtained. Nobody knows why you get those gifts. Just look at the giver. Does he say that he loves you because you are pretty? Does he say that he loves you because you love him back? Does he say that he loves you because you did good things to him? And if he is able to quote any reason, then avoid him. But if you can just not comprehend the love of the giver, then you must know that he is the right giver. Right love and the right giver will always be beyond comprehension. You will always be troubled thinking about why you are receiving that love. Because you will not find any reason. And the mind feels vexed, irritated, when it cannot discover a reason. And the mind feels greatly, absolutely threatened when it finds that it is receiving a lot for no reason. then the mind starts feeling suffocated, because the worldview of the mind is that everything happens for a reason. The worldview of the mind is that life is a trade, an exchange. And if the mind starts getting bountiful without having to pay anything back, then the mind is brought almost to death. The fundamental belief of the mind is then challenged and defeated and destroyed. The mind cannot tolerate this. The mind says, kindly stop giving. If you are giving me without reason, kindly stop giving. Because the mind does not know unconditional love. The mind only knows love that proceeds with barter, exchange. The mind only knows love that proceeds on reciprocity. So the mind becomes agitated. The mind can make no sense of this love. The mind can make no sense of the giver. The mind says, I prefer not to receive the gift than to receive a gift for no reason. Such is the stupidity of the mind. The mind says, I would rather not receive the gift than receive it without knowing the reason. But the fact of the matter is, if the gift is real and if the giver is real, there is never going to be any reason. Now this will frustrate us no end. You have to tell me some reason. Why are you giving me all this? Because I want to be equal with you. Because I want to feel that you are not doing me a favor. If you are giving me without reason, then I'll have to feel grateful. I don't want to feel grateful. I want to feel like a businessman. I want to feel that you are just returning a favor. I want to feel that you are just making an advance payment. I want to feel that the payment will be soon balanced out and neutralized. I want to feel that this is just a business deal. Because if it is not a business deal, then I'll have to surrender in gratitude. I do not want to surrender in gratitude. Kindly tell me that I deserve what you are giving me. Kindly tell me that you expect something in return. He says, no, I do not expect anything in return. Then you know that he is demanding the highest price. By not demanding anything from you, he is demanding your ego. You very well know what a shrewd businessman this real giver is. He is saying, I want no ordinary price. I want that which you hold as the most valuable. Your ego. Come, surrender. Come. Say a heartfelt word of thanks. You do not know how to say that. Your response is, stop giving me. I can tolerate that. But do not ask me to utter thanks, because I do not know what thankfulness is. Because I just cannot believe that someone can love me without wanting anything in return. I cannot believe that. Rumi is saying, look not at yourself. There is nothing about you that has brought the gift to you. There is just nothing about you. And when you get a gift without deserving it, it is called grace. When you get Something, because you have earned it, it is called business. We are so used to business that we become very poor businessmen. When you receive something in grace, then the profit is infinite, because you have earned without investing anything. It is 20,000% profit. You feel ecstatic when instead of 40% your profit margin rises to 45%. But when grace is giving you something at the profit margin of 1,00,000%, then you feel suspicious. You say, why am I receiving it? Such poor business people we are. We are all right with 45%, not all right with 1,00,000%, not all right with an infinite percent profit. The real businessman is the one who earns unlimited profits. You earn unlimited profits when you get that which is unlimited and which you do not deserve at all. Now that is some profit. Be a real businessman. A saint has put it very beautifully. He says, my Lord is a businessman. Sai mera baniya. Pal pal kare vyapar. He is all the time dealing in business. Sai mera baniya, pal pal kare vyapar. Bin dandi, bin palada, tole sab sansar. With no measurement and with no scale, he is weighing the entire world. Get the greatest and get the greatest for free. Then you have shown some skill. But if it is for free, then you become suspicious. You say, no, I would rather have the small. There is another argument that you have. I have heard that argument. If something can come to me, whether or not I deserve it, then it can also be taken away without my consent. I don't want to live in insecurity. But if something is coming to me because I deserve it, then it cannot be taken away. I will call the police. you see, I deserved it, I earned it. Now if somebody tries to take it away, then I will call the police. So there I have security. But if something is coming to me just as a matter of grace, then I don't deserve it, so I don't have a right over it. So I can have no protection of any law. I don't want to live in insecurity. So you take away whatever you have brought to me. I will take only that which I feel I deserve. Because I want to reserve the right of calling the police. If you are giving me something, then I need to feel assured that it will never be taken away. And the only assurance that I know is of force and society. I do not know the assurance of love. So many arguments we have for rejecting the real giver. There is nothing that troubles us so much as when we receive a free gift. We smell fish, we see conspiracies. How is this just coming like this to me? What is the fine print? What is written between the lines? What is it that I am not seeing? Surely somebody is out to loot me. There are no free lunches. Why am I receiving this for free? What's the deal, dude? Come on, show your real face. I'm pretty sure this is just a bait. Soon you'll be fishing me. God Almighty, I know you. I know your crooked ways. I know you are out to make a fool of me. I won't let that happen. I will reject what you are giving me. Now do you know why so many people receive grace? Because we smell fish. Ah, so much has come. For free? Ha! What do you think? I'm a fool to accept this? Come on, I'm too experienced to fall in such traps. Think and think hard. Why is the giver giving? Why is the giver giving? Find no reason and reject the gift. He must be having some agenda. Maybe international expansion. God is some autocrat, I think. Imagine someday Amazon knocks at your door. and says, here is your supply of infinite gold. Can you visualize yourself signing the receipt? Can you visualize yourself? In fact, you will rush inside, bolt the door and hide. You will say, surely a lot of trouble is coming my way.
There is a bomb in the box.
Infinite gold, so the bomb has to be infinitely large. There is no way you are going to just smile and accept. It cannot happen. Give it for free and nobody takes it. That is why grace finds so few takers, because it is for free. If you take something for free, the price that you pay is the highest. The price is the ego. The price is that you will have to surrender and feel grateful. So you don't want to take things for free. Paying money is easier. In fact, that is a very important thing about the mind. If you want to deal with the world, you must know this fact about human psychology. If you really want to give something precious to the other, never make him feel that he is getting it for free, because then he will reject it. If you want to give something really precious to the other, avoid making him feel that he is getting it for free. If he gets an impression that he is getting it for free, he will reject what you are giving. So even if you are actually giving it for free, just charge something. Give him an impression that he deserves it, that is why he is getting it. Give him an impression that it is a business deal. Only then will he receive what you are giving. He needs to be kept in an impression that gratitude is not needed. He needs to feel that he paid for what he received. Are you getting this? Give it for free and you have assured that your gift will not be accepted. So charge something. Now he will receive your gift. At the stalls, if you start distributing books for free, then your books will be used. To wrap Bhelpuri. It is very important that you charge. It's a strange thing.